Hachette Audio presents The Astonishing Mistakes of Dahlia Moss. Written by Max Wirestone. Read by Lauren Fortgang. For Clay, expectedly. And Yoko Shimomura, somewhat less so. Chapter 1. The internet was making fun of me. I couldn't blame the internet, honestly. Things were going very badly. I had been on some disastrous arena runs, double 1-3 records, and the commentariat was letting me have it. That's what happens when you're losing while streaming to an audience on Twitch. Then again, it's also what happens when you're winning. The internet, as a rule, just likes making fun of things. This did not bother me so much. I mean, it bothered me in a global sense, as in, internet, I see this is why we can't have nice things. But it didn't unnerve me. What unnerved me was the tip jar, which suddenly had $500 in it. Grief I expect, money I do not. Let's be clear, I am not a major streamer. I'd only even started it a month ago, when money from my last case meant I could afford a computer nice enough to stream without lagging. And while I'm sure there are big-shot streamers who wouldn't be all that surprised by a $500 donation, I'm no big shot, as my double 1-3 records would attest. "Wow," I said. "That's super nice of you, Dr. XXX. Thanks for the cash." The donor's name was Dr. Triple X, incidentally. I'm not redacting to protect anybody. Nobody in this adventure gets protected. "Cool," typed Dr. Triple X. "What the fuck?" said the rest of the Twitch chat. "What the actual fuck?" I'm summarizing because there were probably 50 guys in the channel typing away like spider monkeys, but this was the gist of it. Everyone could see the tip jar. There was actually a little animation of an oinking piggy bank that played. And the question of the moment was, who the hell would tip 500 to me? A noob with a 1-3 record. Honestly, I was a little with Twitch chat on this one. Let's consider. 1, some people on the internet are creepers. 2, people who give you large sums of money for no apparent reason probably have a reason. Creepers be real, y'all. I don't want to hit this point too hard, but the two questions I'm most asked on Twitch are, do you have a boyfriend, and where do you live? As it happens, the answers are kind of and St. Louis, although when I answer this for Twitch, I round the kind of up to a yes, definitely he's very strong, and Missouri. So I tried to play the $500 thing coolly, like this was the kind of thing that happened all the time. Oh, another 500 bucks from a nameless stranger? Cool, I guess. Thanks for watching. But Twitch chat did not play it coolly, because cool is not a part of the internet's wheelhouse. How to explain Twitch chat, really? It's a bit like if the mouth breathers who wrote YouTube comments could type really fast and were also dangerously caffeinated. Dangerously caffeinated. Like Trish's maniac boyfriend on Jessica Jones, but after the mind-altering drugs. Anyway, Twitch was all like, Dr. Triple X wants some action. Romantic action was the implication, because why else would anyone suck up to a girl with a 1-3 record? Or so went their reasoning. Although they conveyed this idea with considerably more lewdness than I just managed. It was moments like this that made me generally glad that Twitch didn't know my name. My handle on Twitch is Sunkern, named for my second favorite Pokemon. My favorite Pokemon is Jigglypuff, but I didn't want to run a channel with the word jiggly in it. And even Puff suggests a marijuana-themed production that I do not have the funds or endurance to provide. So, Sunkern. Haha, you guys. Let's start another arena run. Go hang yourself, said Twitch chat. Could I message you privately? Asked Dr. Triple X, and I thought, oh, Lord, here it is, Creeper City. Let's not, I said, trying to sound cheerful and bright. Just type whatever you want to say in front of everyone. Now, what class should we choose for the next run? Shaman? Warrior? Priest? Burnt, said Twitch chat. I'm paraphrasing. Dahlia done stole all your money. Only they didn't say Dahlia because I am secretive. In fact, I've even slipped on the channel and accidentally used my real name, which as far as they know is Louise. I'm opening the voting right now, I told the chat. I know this is going to sound forward, typed Dr. Triple X, but I was wondering if you could come to the Endicott Hotel in St. Louis tomorrow. No, I cannot. This is not the vanishing Dr. Triple X. But I did not say that aloud. I just smiled at the votes, which were all for Priest, the worst possible class, because these guys were fucking with me, every last one of them. Gosh, I don't know, Dr. Triple X, I said, trying to sound positive and not at all concerned. I have a plan for tomorrow. This was true in that my plan was not to be drugged and murdered in a hotel. Meeting someone named Dr. Triple X at a place I had never heard of was so obviously a bad idea that even Twitch was against it. Don't do it, said Twitch chat with all caps and exclamation points and kappas, which are these screaming disembodied heads that are hard to explain because they don't make a lot of sense out of context. Actually, now that I think about it, they don't make a lot of sense in context, but no matter. Even a Twitch chatter whose name was, and I'm not making this up, the Grim Raper, typed, Louise, I hope you're not seriously thinking of going to this hotel. There was a lot of uproar. For a group of people who tended to complain about white knights, Twitch chat was being positively paternal. Take his money and mute him, said Twitch chat. Take all the money. But Dr. Triple X just kept on typing. There's going to be a tournament there tomorrow. For Dark Allies, kind of a big deal. The winning team is going to take home $20,000. Yeah, I said. I heard about that, but I don't really play a lot of fighters. This was sort of a lie because I had gotten slightly obsessed with Skullgirls for a while, but this was a detail Dr. Triple X did not need to know, besides which, being good in one fighting game doesn't mean you're going to be any good in another. The sports equivalent is sort of like, oh, I heard you like soccer, so I figured you'd be great at ice hockey. Yes, the two sports are very broadly speaking similar, but the devil is really in the details, as you'll discover when you break your legs as you try to run across a sheet of ice. Some serious stuff is going to go down at that tournament, said Dr. Triple X. Sounds like a fun day, I told him, right-clicking to bring up the mute option. And I think that there should be a detective on hand. And that stopped me cold, because who was Dr. Triple X to be aware of the Dahlia Moss geek detective phenomenon? As far as Twitch chat knew, my name was Louise, no last name. And the only mysteries I'd ever solve for them were Nancy Drew hidden puzzle games, which I actually struggled with a lot. Dr. Triple X knew who I was. Why do you think there should be a detective on hand? I asked, with as much disinterest as I could feign. I don't want to say in chat, typed Dr. Triple X. But if you showed up, I could tell you in person. I'll be wearing a green hat if you do. I hope you do. Girl, don't, said Twitch chat. I don't know why I'm making Twitch sound like my gay best friend, because that is fundamentally not their vibe. You better just take that money and forget this scrub. Swooshy hand, finger snap. See, I keep doing it. But I listened to Twitch, actually. I know that seems kind of out of character, actually taking someone's good advice. But with all those kappas and exclamation points, how could I not? I clicked mute on the drop-down menu and said, all right, let's start another run. I even went 7-3, and I made $500, so I was having a pretty good night. But that's just it, isn't it? Things are always great until the bodies start piling up. Chapter 2. My roommate Charisse has this theory about curiosity killing the cat. People always throw that line out at you as though the cat has gotten into something he shouldn't have, right? There was a mysterious noise that he shouldn't have investigated, or a scent that he shouldn't have tracked down. The implication is always that the cat looked for something evil, and the terrible thing he discovered bumped him off. The moral is, don't be curious. Charisse's theory, on the other hand, is that the cat never investigated the noise, never tracked the scent. He died from curiosity the way a young lover might die from pining. He yearned to find out what was around the corner.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.